Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. Oh, hello, copyright-free cartoon character. Welcome. Our planet is changing, and it's not looking good. Go back in time between the years of 1961 and 1990, and on average, you have statistically super hot days about 37 times a year. But just last year, in 2017, we clocked around 60 extremely hot days. That's nearly double. This does mean we can go to the beach a lot more, but what if when we got to the coast, there was less and less land to sit on every year? This is called sea level rise, and it's both real and pretty terrifying. Eventually, our beaches and cities might disappear. I'm talking to you, New York. You should pay attention. You see, as the Earth gets hotter, seawater expands and ice sheets, glaciers, and frozen places like Greenland and Antarctica add water to the ocean as they melt. Put together, the sea level rises, and as it does so, it needs a place to expand into. And the only place is further up onto the land. Based off of current models on sea level rise, within around 10 years, we could see the ocean creeping up onto certain islands and low-lying areas throughout the world. Given enough time, it's possible that they could be covered by the ocean. In fact, the Solomon Islands in the Pacific have already started to vanish. The Solomon Islands, which are made up of volcanic islands and coral atolls, have lost 5 vegetated reef islands, with another 6 islands experiencing severe shoreline recession, all forcing people to move and rebuild. This may not seem like a big deal to all my friends out there that are surrounded by a bunch of land, but 8 of the largest cities in the world are actually near the ocean. Hey, come on, New York, pay attention. This is for you. Eventually, a rising sea level would cause that water to spill into some of these cities. According to a recent study, based on 25 years of NASA and European satellite data, the global sea level rise isn't even just rising at a steady rate. Researchers found that in recent decades, the rate of global sea level rise has actually been accelerating. The assessment went on further to say that if the rate of ocean rise keeps up at this current pace, the world's sea level will rise about 65 centimeters by 2100, which could cause significant problems for coastal cities. So yeah, definitely not good. Scientists from the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration have weighed in on this too, concluding that by 2100, they're very confident that the global mean sea level will rise by at least 20 centimeters, but that the increase might even get up to as much as 200 centimeters. But it's not like this problem is just gonna wait until 2100. Some of the Netherlands is already below sea level, protected by walls and levees. That does help, but this doesn't seem like an issue that we can just engineer ourselves out of. According to the National Academy of Engineering, flooding risks can never be fully eliminated by walls or other protective structures, no matter how large or sturdy they are. Plus, as things progress, more coastal infrastructure could be destroyed by worsening hurricanes and typhoons. So, yeah, we should probably get to saving the planet. I see New York is panicking and trying to help. Very good. So, would this affect you? Do you live next to an ocean? Are there any natural disasters you'd like me to talk about next? Let me know in the comment section below. Curious to know what technology will look like in 100 years? Check out this video. There are some pretty life-changing inventions predicted to come about in the next century. Flying cars, once thought to be a thing of just science fiction, are actually progressing at lightning speed. A lot of the technology already exists. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.